JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for July the 1st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded lower against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian morning Wednesday. It underperformed the most versus the Canadian dollar, the Norwegian krone, and the British pound in that order, while it lost the least ground versus the Japanese yen. The greenback eked out some gains only against the euro and SEK. The slide in the dollar, combined with the relative weakness in the yen, suggests that risk appetite remains supported for another day. However, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see a more mixed picture. Most major EU bourses traded in negative territory, while later in the US, all three of Wall Street's main indices closed in the green. As for today's Asian session, Japan's Nikkei slid 0.35%, 0.89%, but China's Shanghai Composite gained 0.75%. The mixed picture may have been the result of portfolio rebalancing the last day of the second quarter, and or maybe it is a reflection of the battle we've been highlighting recently between those who believe that the global economy will recover faster than previously anticipated and those who are afraid of another round of fast spreading of the coronavirus around the world. As we noted yesterday, with infected cases hitting a new record on Friday and with several US states reversing their reopenings, we prefer to stay sidelined for now. As for today, market participants may pay extra attention to the minutes from the latest FOMC gathering when the committee decided to keep interest rates unchanged and noted that they will continue to increase purchases of bonds and mortgage-backed securities at least at the current pace, something suggesting that purchases can accelerate again if deemed necessary. Officials already announced tweaks to their bond purchases a few days after the meeting, widening the range of eligible assets to include all US corporate bonds. On top of that, when testifying before Congress, Fed Chair Powell himself said that there is a reasonable probability that more policy support would be needed. He reiterated that view yesterday in another testimony before the House Financial Services Committee. Thus, we will dig into the minutes to see whether other policymakers were in favor of further easing in the foreseeable future. If so, equities may gain on hopes for more central bank support, while the dollar and other safe havens may come under selling pressure. A potential increase in the ISM manufacturing PMI ahead of the minutes may allow investors to start the party earlier. The oil-related Canadian dollar and Norwegian krone were the main gainers yesterday, perhaps due to oil prices gaining on the back of a decline in US crude oil inventories. Yesterday, the American Petroleum Institute reported that inventories tumbled 8.16 million barrels last week after increasing 1.75 million the week before, suggesting that demand is improving despite signs of a new flare-up in infected cases from the coronavirus around the globe. Today we get the Energy Information Administration weekly report, where a confirmation of a strong slide in inventories may encourage some more oil buying and thereby support further the Canadian dollar and the Norwegian krone. Apart from the Fed minutes, the ISM PMI and the Energy Information Administration report, we also have a central bank deciding on interest rates today, and this is the Riksbank. When they last met, policymakers of this bank decided to continue purchases of government and mortgage bonds up to the end of September 2020 and to leave the repo rate unchanged at 0%. They also said that the measures will be adjusted to economic developments. After the meeting, GDP data showed that economic activity slowed to 0.1% quarter over quarter in the first quarter from 0.2%, but this was at a time when expectations were pointing to a 0.6% contraction. The latest inflation data showed that both the CPI and CPIF rates rebounded to 0% year over year in May from minus 0.4%, while the core CPIF metric showed that underlying inflation rebounded to 1.2% from 1%. Therefore, although we may not get any policy changes at this gathering, it would be interesting to see whether the better-than-expected GDP data and the rebound in inflation would trigger any discussion with regards to scaling back QE purchases. Now, as for the rest of today's events, we also have the final market manufacturing PMIs from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, but as it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. Later in the day from the US, ahead of the Fed minutes, we get the ADP employment report for June. Expectations are for the private sector to have gained 3 million jobs after losing 2.76 million in May. This would raise speculation that the NFP print due out tomorrow may also come close to that number. Indeed, the forecast for the NFP is currently at 3.07 million. However, although the ADP is the only major gauge we have for the NFPs, it is far from a reliable predictor. Even last month, when the ADP revealed 2.76 million job losses, the official employment report showed that NFPs increased 2.51 million. Tonight, during the Asian session, and during the Asian session Thursday, we have New Zealand's NZIER Business Confidence Index for the second quarter and Australia's trade balance for May. However, there is no forecast available for neither of those releases. As for the speakers, we have five on today's agenda: Bank of England MPC member Jonathan Haskell, ECB Executive Board member Fabio Panetta, Chicago Fed President Charles Evans, Deutsche Bundesbank Executive Board members Sabine Mauderer and Joachim Wermeling. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.